And so you have all these people that said that a long time ago. There's marijuana activists that are in prison.
There was proof of it, and they got rid of it.
Exactly.
And they put out a study saying that marijuana kills brain cells, and the way that they tested it was by putting like gas masks on monkeys.
Wow.
And pumping them with the equivalent of 100 joints in like an hour, I think.
Right. That's and ridiculous.
And they died because their lack of oxygen.
Wow.
So like people tell me, oh, weed kills brain cells. I'm like, shut the fuck up.
Well, actually,
shut up, you monkey.
There's a weird history of how this all started. There was a newspaper tycoon back in like the early 1900s, and I believe his name was like William Randolph Hearst. And so he had a lot of money invested in paper. And there was a competing venture, this new thing called hemp.
Mm-hmm.
You can grow hemp. You can. I can tell you, as a person who's grown weed before, it harvests every 3 to 4 months, which is really unusual for a plant. It grows really large. So like the potential for it to be used for a lot of things, like rope and I've heard it can be used as cement. Mm-hmm. Like there's so many random things you wouldn't even think of. It can be used for like infrastructure things, and so William Randolph Hearst, who was the tycoon of this newspaper industry,
mm-hmm.
who had money invested in paper as the foundation of this country, he used his newspapers to publish stories about Mexicans and Negroes.
Yeah.
That was the word he used,
yeah.
That they raped white women when
yep.
they were on this substance,
and
they got wild. And
they would have white women listen to their funky
it's
jazz music
yeah.
and
it's
stuff.
It's crazy how history repeats itself, because that's exactly the kind of things Donald Trump was saying to give precedence to building the wall. Mexicans are bringing rapists and all their thugs and all this kind of
yeah.
stuff. It's just like racism.
Yeah,
it's like the same.
Was that the guy? Did that guy also have something to do with Reefer Madness?
I think that was later, but that's where I was about to touch on this point. This
mm-hmm.
is where the Reefer Madness thing builds from, because it's like it literally gets you mad and rapes white women.
Yeah,
you know? You touch white women.
And that's usually, as you well know, it's like that's like one of the touch points emotionally that they always use to get after the public, especially back in those
mm-hmm.
days. Is like, oh my God, they're gonna come after your white women. You know, and it's like
the prize position.
Yeah, it's just insidious. But that ties
crazy.
That ties into what I wanted to what we were touching on earlier. All these people who are in jail for marijuana, they have their voting rights taken away,
mm-hmm.
which is kind of a way of targeting a certain group
yep.
Who they know that they vote a certain way. You can see the monologue in the beginning and see what we're referencing. They know that black people are a monolith. They vote a very certain way. And, you know, if you're, they all vote Democrat and you're Republican and you want to take down Democratic voters,
mm-hmm.
this is a way you do it. And, you know, Reagan was really the heart of this, so.
Exactly. Look who supports private prisons and criminalizing marijuana. Republicans.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hard right leading Republicans. Marco Rubio, I read about how he was funded like by a couple hundred thousand from a corporation that runs a private prison. That's why I was telling people not to vote for him, because he was going to keep these things going. And so you see, it's like a crazy way, crazy lunatic way of taking away voting rights from black and brown or poor people in general, and because they know who they vote for. And it's awful. But
yeah,
the state of Florida was one of the, oh, it was a state Hillary Clinton could have won, but it was like 300,000 felons in Florida, and like a couple hundred of those were black men. And so it was a lot of votes that she could have got in Florida, but this criminalization.
Yeah. And the same thing with Gore
tainted.
Before her. Gore also famously lost Florida, and the exact same thing happened to him, and it was much closer. It was hundreds of votes, maybe thousands of tops. Like, that's all he needed. He was even closer than Hillary taking the whole thing and erasing George Bush. And so you could literally say that taking away the voting rights of black men has caused us to have George W. Bush and Donald Trump instead of Al Gore and Hillary Clinton. And so that's a price white people have to pay. You put black people in jail, they're your best ally. They are the ones, like I always said in my stand-up, Jews and black people are like the canaries in the coal mine of oppression. They're usually the first ones to get hit. So once you know they get hit, everyone else will get hit. And so those are your best allies, the people who always are, you know, the subjects of discrimination. And then when those people get hit and you don't do anything, guess what's going to happen? You're going to live in a country like where you live with Trump and live with George W. Bush.
Hmm.